and home of the Fight Show. I'm Maniac Mike. New Year's Revolution, here we are.
Hey, Vera. Can you ground here? Let me help you run down this tall maniac. First of all, we have this debacle of a tag team elimination tournament to face the Bradley Bros for the titles. I forced in action.
Indeed, but that's not all, Kenny. Fatal four-way table inmate number one contender match. You'll see me in there too. I'm looking for a chance to get that belt back. Also, Jimmy Johnson taking on Mr. Black for the inmate title. This is a grudge match, and Jimmy requested this be a table match as well. And in our main event, the Fourth Warden Fight Club Lightweight Championship champion Zach Shuck takes on Yorgi Von Karen. Let's take a look at the tag team bracket as Kenny runs backstage to get ready for his match. I like booking him this way. His blood's all pumping from the interviews and from yelling at me, complaining about Mr. Black. He's recruited his own tag team partner, and they'll be going up against Chaos, a really unheard of tag team from China, who I think is gonna make a big name for themselves here on the Fight Show. Kenny Grime, of course, bringing his brand of clotheslines and massacre plots, bit of roughneck wrestling, and his accomplice Angus is known for having quite a headbutt. That's all he told me. Of course, Chaos, with their extensive martial art background, shall be up for this challenge.
Kenny Grime here, again forced into action, made to put my body in harm's way. Maniac says I got tag team talent. I feel tag team gold. Yeah, like 5 years ago. Okay, so I rolled in with the punches, is this. This is Angus.
I am Angus.
He don't say many words, but what he does say is he is Angus.
I am Angus.
Anyway, dude can fight. He saved my ass once, literally. I did some time, and Angus here saved me from the shower rapers. So when he got out, I offered him a job as my tag partner. We gonna put a massacre plotting down on the Bradley Bros.
I plot because I am Angus.
Yeah, and that. It's really such a minor character flaw to put up with.
I have small flaws because I am Angus.
This is the first match of 2016. It is a tag team contest. Introducing the team of Kenny Grime and Angus, the Misfits.
I don't know about Misfits. I don't know about this team martyr either, Warlock having a laugh at my expense. I did ask him to recruit a partner to help me fill out the tournament bracket, and he graciously accepted, apparently, for the company, so I thank you.
And their opponents, the tag team all the way from China, they are Thunder Song and the Tornado Team Chaos.
This match, you know what? This is probably one of my more exciting matches for me. I'm really excited to see Chaos in action together here on the Fight Show against Kenny Grime and his newly recruited partner Angus. This is not gonna be easy for Chaos. Grime and Thunder starting it off. The quickness of Thunder getting the upper hand on Kenny. Kenny wrestling him into a clothesline there. He's not letting him go. Two for the price of one. Kenny Grime, a master of execution when it comes to throwing his clubbing arms at people's faces and throats. Whipping Thunder into the corner. Thunder reversing. And Kenny delivering another clothesline. Thunder trying to get out of that corner, which is a good idea. You do not want to be stuck there. And Kenny Grime going to work with those boots. Thunder landing a wonderful kick on a reversal there, but Grime putting him back down. Kenny told me he hasn't been in action, but he looks pretty sharp to me. Uh-oh, what's this? Oh, Hurricana Rana! From that top turnbuckle, Kenny Grime looking confused, which of course means he's gonna flail his arms around and start stomping anything that moves. Which happens to work out well for him in wrestling. Oh, it's not a place you want to be, a headlock at Kenny Grime. Tornado trying to work up some momentum, but Grime keeping on the pressure. Not sure. He calls at the solar plexus. It still looks like a stomp to the balls, but Tornado into the outstretched feet of Angus, and now we get to see the new fight show acquisition in action. Heading across the ring, wanting a bit of Thunder, maybe forgetting what kind of match we're in here. And he's greeted back in the ring by two kicks by Tornado. Tornado using his speed, keeping the giant Angus off his balance. Angus landing that kick to the jaw or knee. And a hard whip into the corner. And he's hung him upside down. What's he got? Oh, brutal drop kick to the face. Taking a reversal there. The elbow snuck in. Tornado got him in the corner. Neckbreaker. But Angus right back up, trying to clear his head. Keeping on the pressure. Tornado working on the knee. That's one way to take down these tall competitors. A roll up, sneak up pin, two. And it's reversed. Two, reversed again. Oh my goodness. I'm getting confused as to who's pinning who. Somebody stop the madness. Finally. Tornado rescuing his partner from the insanity. Oh, Angus really going to work now. Landing those knees to the ribs, a nice punch, and tagging in Kenny Grime. They're looking like a oiled machine, but with Kenny, a well-greased machine. Tornado building a little bit here. Can he get going? An unorthodox team for them to face here in their tag team debut. How do you prepare for Wildness. Tornado in, or Tornado making the tag. Thunder nailing Grime in the midsection. That was quite a fall. And perhaps making a mistake by following him to the outside, where he's now being double teamed. Well, trying to fight out of that situation anyway. The flurry of kicks. Grime back up on the apron. Oh, landing that knee so flush. And that was the shot that made all of this worthwhile. Angus sending him back in the ring. Damage done. Thunder slow to get up. Since we have eliminated the knockouts, many of our fighters are most likely fighting concussed from time to time. Not sure I agree with the decision. Angus with a submission hold, cutting off the air supply. Tornado trying to break it up, but Grime keeping him busy. Finally, the hold broken. Little bit of order restored to the ring. Angus looking for a chance to finish it off, and Thunder not wanting to be defeated quite so easily. That knee to the back, and is he gonna make the tag? Yes, he does. Angus looking for the tag too. Grime and Tornado, the freshmen, going right to the arm of Grime. Again, going for the strength. Taking out the clothesline. Whoa! Oh, not a second time. He ran right into that clothesline. Oh, that knee. And he goes for the cover. Just a two. Folks, you can smell the end is near. Oh, the arm of Angus wrenched and tweaked. Tornado making the tag. Thunder in and ducked by Angus. Making the tag himself. Grime in. Reversed. The martial art leverage maneuver. Oh, kick right to the midsection. Sending Grime sprawling. Tornado in. Keeping this quick pace tag action going. Grime pulling him to the middle of the ring, making a pin attempt. Just a two. Perhaps just a setup. Oh, nailed him right in the... Oh, stomping him in the chest. Oh, massacre! Nailing him. It's over.
The winner of the match, the tag team of Angus and Kenny Grime.
Grime and Angus, victorious here against Chaos. Moving on into the second round of this tag team tournament. Very impressive showing for the first time tag team. So Kenny Grime and Angus victorious in their debut as a tag team, and can't say I'm surprised, although I can say I had hope for a little better from Chaos, but I will give them another chance to prove themselves. Up next, the cleverly named team of the Martyrs, named by Warlock, I guess in jest, taking on the team of Samuel and Eric Von Karen, who have taken it upon themselves to dress as pirates to go with our New Year's Revolution theme. Folks, Warlock, a bit of a mystery. Cyborg, we've seen a bit of. He strong, skilled, technical. Samuel, definitely a brawler. He's got some technical ability. Eric can do anything.
Introducing the tag team of the Warlock and the Cyborg of Mercury. They are the Martyrs.
Oh man. Gotta love this Warlock guy. He says, Maniac, do you mind if I
put together a creative entrance for me and my compatriot? Some
BS like that. Oh. You know, it's funny in like this behind the scenes kind of way, but not so funny on the pocketbook kind of way. Mugging it up. Well, put together a good match, man, and I'll forget about it. Well, at least they had fun with it, you know? You gotta give them that. Wonder what kind of smoke that stuff they're pumping in here. If that's against code or not. It's the kind of thing Billy used to let me know.
There is a 28% chance that the Bradley Bros will burn. An 18% chance that the Cyborg will burn the Bradley.
Cyborg, I think we should tell the crowd about our prowess and wit. How we will overcome the odds and be champions at the night's end.
Yes, and then we burn.
They sail the 420 seas. These are two of Brothers 3, Samuel and Eric von Kevin. I do not think there are 420 seats. I'm sorry.
I don't think an apology is needed there. Definitely not 420 seas to my knowledge, but these guys are definitely sailing on something. Say I disagree. It's a beautiful smell. It's just, you know, before a fight? Not me. The two, like, just mastodon behemoths. Pardon the use of your name, oh great one. Oh man, that guy. You'll notice Mastodon missing from action as he explained heavyweight champions don't fight unless there's a worthy challenger, and he took out a Mega Man, well, admittedly fairly easily at season's beating, so I gotta find this dude someone to fight, and I'm not really sure who's next. I don't know. Warlock slamming Sam's head back on that wood. We have a wooden, some kind of stick-on wood crap on the ring this week. The wrestlers insisted, you know, it's not like as hard as the concrete. It's like, got a point, but I'm also be landing on it. It'd be nice to not land on wood, but who am I to argue with the majority? Cyborg in there. Very unorthodox. Uses a lot of leverage and pressure point type maneuvers. as we see there. Ooh, the raw strength of Omega Man Sam, growing out his locks and his facial hair, I see. We do not have a policy here on Fight Show, as you can see by Kenny Time. I think if we did, the first hair I would have go would be maybe Mr. Black and Mr. Grime. Oh, crap. Grime and Black. Maybe a little body waxing. I don't know. The body hair is a bit much. For those who don't know, our farmer partner, Billy Lowenstein. Oh, what a bulldog. Sam getting ahead of steam here. Whipping him hard into the ropes, and he goes up high into the stratosphere. Our ex-partner, Mr. Lowenstein, pulled kind of a jack move. He had written in some weird clause with the farmer owners, I might add. He lands the Phoenix Splash to the back with the farmer owners. A Fight Show, and he robbed a lot of these guys of their gimmicks, their names, their reputations. Few of the more savvy ones saw through it. Others, desperate for a little bonus, were eager to sign the clauses. But we're past that. Oh, DDT! And Eric Von Karen, the failed mixed martial artist. I mean, not failed in a bad way, just too violent for the sport. Goes to work against the Warlock. He just walked out of the woods one day when McKenny and I were at a burger shack. And said, "You've been looking for me?" And I said, "Not me, I don't really do drugs." And Kenny is like, "Wow, what you got?" And I was like, excuse me. But anyway, turned out he just wanted a job. So after some tests, he passed a few initiation matches with a few of our other rookies, and here he is for his second match. Wow, look at Cyborg go. He just, it's like, his movements are very confusing, but then he actually does something at the end, so it's like, ooh. Backdrop, and that one was done with a lot of leverage. Again, you do not want to take these punches from Eric Von Karen. They are full of years of violence and resentment. Living in the shadow of Mr. Black, feuding with his brother Samuel Von Karen for a decade. Oh, what a beautiful move there. We are starting to see the potential that the world talked about in their youth, which we've been robbed of by their father, Mr. Black. Split the brothers apart, set them against each other to make Eric a champion, a world champion. Of course, neither brother has achieved a world championship on any level in any federation. Cyborg with those mechanical chops, working on the weak spots of his opponent. What's he doing here? That looks in pretty deep, but Eric's there with the save. Oh, what a punch to the jaw. And in comes the middleman, the middle brother, Eric Von Karen, going for a ride as his kick is caught and he's dragon screwed. To the back. Again, Cyborg just working on the joints, on the weak spots of the human anatomy. And Eric cares nothing about weak spots. He goes right up the middle, right to the face. Survive this. And a nice sweep there. Those clubbing fists hitting with accuracy, just pounding away. Gross! Cyborg emitting some green goo into the face. I don't know if that mask protect Eric or not, but it certainly lit a fire as he's going off into the corner, but Cyborg too slippery. Warlock in, trying to take advantage of Eric as he's trying to clean that green goo off his face. Measures it and drives the knee down across the forehead. A motionless Von Karen, only a one, kicking out maybe by instinct. Behind, German suplex. Dragon suplex. He loves to mix those two into a pinning combo, but only getting one there as Warlock goes to the throat and staggering him. It's a quick roll up. Just a one. And Eric again showing why he's earned the moniker, the natural. That flurry was all around him, and he was king of it for a moment. A knee to the forehead. Oh, capture suplex. This could be over. In the middle of the ring. What's he got? Can Warlock help him? Is there enough? Is he gonna submit? No, he lets him go. The longtime fighter knowing when he does not have the hold, you don't want to gas yourself. Let it go. Get it in deeper. Cyborg emitting that green goo again all over his hand. And he's got a claw locked on. Into a pinning. Oh no. And he's out. Not sure of the rules on that. Oh my goodness, three. You can't do, oh, he folds him in half. He calls that the exhaust. My God, I'm looking so nervously over at the commissioner over there. And he's enjoying our complimentary beverage. Von Karen again pulling off that suplex combo and getting in a pin attempt. Cyborg making the tag. And Eric ducks underneath it, making the tag himself. Samuel in. Warlock ducks. In the middle, they tie up. The arm and the leverage and not letting go as he drives a knee across the arm, going for that pin, not sure why. Oh, he's got him, but Cyborg's there to save his partner. Belly to belly. I didn't know he was that strong. That's pretty cool. He's got the Von Karens on the run, too, now. Cyborg and Warlock, the martyrs, may become the champions tonight. Although they're both... Oh! The top of Mount Omega! The Omega Man! 2-on-1. The numbers overwhelm them. Sam back in the ring. Warlock back in. The tag being made. It's so wonderful to see the Von Karen brothers back in action. As Eric takes Cyborg off the apron and sets Warlock up. Way up. Oh my goodness. That's over, isn't it? No, he's not taking the pin now. That took a lot of energy to do. Sam looking to finish off Warlock, no doubt. Dropkick. 300 pounds of muscle. Jumping 6'5" in the air and hitting you in the face. Just a two, but man, the damage is done. Power slam! And a jumping elbow! This could be over, but no, he's got fight left. Man! What a spine buster! Warlock looking a little hazy-eyed. Chopped down across the Omega Man's forehead. And again back to that surgically repaired knee of the Omega Man. You're not going to get him that close. Eric there right away to break up that submission attempt. Samuel coming back. That's not gonna do it. You're gonna need more. Russian leg sweep and perhaps the chance of a comeback fading here. Into the ropes. Oh! I didn't even know that move existed. Eric going to work with those kicks, but reversed. Oh! There's a pin attempt. Two. It's hard to call this one. They've both fought so hard. Oh, digging those claws into the head of Eric Von Karen. Warlock is a ferocious and devious fighter. Eric looking pissed off. Whipped to the corner. What's going on here? Oh, oh! Eric Von Karen dodging, landing that elbow across the neck there, and landing those punches with accuracy, the sickening thuds, a cover, and a victory, a win.
The winners of the match, the Von Karens.
Those were some pretty crazy blows he took at the end there. Those were some unpadded punches. Warlock still down. Hopefully he'll be okay for our Valentine's Day show. Von Karen's moving on. So the Von Karen's moving past the team of the martyrs, who I have to say I was really impressed with. Not sure if they're the right team, but they both showed a lot of potential in that match. action, I was very impressed with Warlock. Von Cairns came out of a very tightly contested matchup. What do they have left for the Misfits? This should be a very fun matchup. Angus, Kenny Grime, proving to be quite the combination. But is it enough for the experience, the natural connection that two brothers would have in the ring? We'll find out, and we'll find out soon. I have word something's going on in the locker room, though.
Mom down, Eric! Get the medic! Get the chopper!
This place is going down. Down quick.
This is the number one contender matchup. The first team to reach the finals. Angus and Kenny Grime, the Misfits.
Well, they're looking jacked and ready to go, really. Chaos, more of a warm-up match for these two tonight. That was disappointing, but good job on these guys.
The second team in this number one contender tag team final matchup, Eric Von Cairns and Samuel Von Cairns. The winner of this match will face the Bradley Bros in a Fort Walton Fight Club Tag Team Championship match.
Yeah, you can feel the excitement in here. Suddenly we are faced with quite a matchup, really. The famous Kenny Time from Ultraviolet Wrestling fame, and the famed Von Cairns brothers all in the ring here. All on the fight show. And he stiffens them up right out of the gates. Looking for a quick win, but nope. Do not brawl between. Whoa! It was a setup for that submission hold. Kenny Grime already picking up a win with that on our last show. And a bear hug now. Testing just how badly Warlock and Cyborg roughed up Sam last match. A clothesline across the chest. Sam getting pissed. Grime doesn't care. Delivering his slap. Belly, belly, overhead. Grime on wobbly legs into the Von Cairns corner, and Eric going up. Connecting on that assisted suplex. And Von Cairns working that clothesline and arm, which also happens to be his beer drinking arm and butt scratching arm from what I've observed. Angus in trying to fight against someone you should not be standing toe to toe with. And he's folded in half with that suplex. Whipped hard into the Von Cairns corner, but not falling prey for that double team. He delivers a knee on the way out. Grime back in the ring. Met with the feet. Into the ropes goes Eric, and what a hard hip toss that was. Kenny Grime sitting down into that hip toss, delivering a slap combo, diving and making a tag. Angus coming in, but Von Karens are quick. Eric ducks that punch. But into a hammerlock. Samuel coming in. Double teaming Angus into the corner. Setting him up for something big. Grime not aware. Angus going for a ride. And that was amazing. Oh, I'm sorry. That was natural. Amazin's their brother. Trying to put a combo together, but Angus sneaking in some blocks. Eric into the corner. Tag is made, and their own assisted suplex. This time, Grimes' big flabby body. Oh! Spearing Sammy off of the apron. Against our guest table, our sponsor and the commissioner making sure we, I don't know what he's making sure. I've seen some pretty shady crap going on this week, and he doesn't seem to do much about anything. Folded in half again. Dude's been folded twice. He's a quarter size now from those suplexes. It's one thing you can double team effort out there. Eric shrugging Kenny off. Kenny finally getting Eric into the ring. Eric became focused on brawling with Angus on the outside. Spinning backhand, landing flush, and rolling him into some kind of an armbar. Angus making the save. Landing that kick to the back of the head, then to the ribs. Eric going to work. Landing kicks, punches with accuracy. Takedown. There's a dodge there by Grime. Oh, backdrop. And Eric making the tag to Samuel. Kenny Grime ducking that punch. Grime hard into the corner. And again with the assisted suplex. Grime laid out flat. Something in him is fighting back. The thought of losing beer money, maybe. Or maybe losing to Pirates, who knows? Kenny Grime pulling Eric to the center of the ring and making the pin attempt. Getting a two count. Nice body slam. Whoa, back body drop. And Eric's fighting back now. He's got his leg all wrapped up on the Von Karen side of the ring. But Angus again making the save. Perhaps his most valuable tool is that of being timely on the saves, but let's... Can he save Kenny here? Kenny working his way out. Looking for Angus for the tag, but he's not there. He leaves his back wide open. But Angus is there saving his behind once again. And Kenny Grime rolls up Eric Von Karen. And he went. That's a pin.
The winner of the match. And moving on to face the Bradley Bros for the Fourth Rotten Fight Club Tag Team Champions. Kenny Grime and Angus, the Misfits.
Looked like Sam didn't realize what was going on, but hey, you snooze, you lose. Misfits, moving on. Me meds are kicking in too, just about in time as well. Here we are at the pinnacle of this tag team tournament, the Misfits, surviving two grueling matches to earn the right to fight the Bradley Bros. It doesn't seem fair, and should things go awry, perhaps I'll rectify things at the Massacre next month. Bradley Bros, notorious for cheating and taking the underhanded and easy route. You know, normally I wouldn't feel bad for Kenny Grime, but this is quite a mountain. But let's see if Grime and his new recruit can take the tag team titles. I caught up with the Bradley Bros, of course. Maniac Mike here with Fight Show Tag Team Champions, the Bradley Bros. It was the two of you who came up with the idea of defending your belts this way. Any comments?
Hey, forget about it, Evan. It was me. I was like, bam, idea.
Yo, bro, I did forget it. That was you?
Oh, yeah. Suckers, let's go get some ice cream, bro.
Oh, I was gonna have the ice cream, bro. I guess I'll have to have the fro-yo, bro. Let's go. Yo, we asked the like pasta.
Out. These guys make me feel like I'm going crazy.
This contest is for the 4th Ward and Fight Club's Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, the current reigning tag team champions, Jordan and Griffin Bradley.
Rather than talk through Bradley Bros' entrance, I thought I'd just let you listen to them ramble a bit. I mean, they have anything to say, but it's just kind of funny, I guess. In some way, when your meds are kicking in, everything's a bit funny. Like, Kenny has to call the next match after this, whether he wins or loses.
This match is for the 4th Ward and Fight Club Tag Team Championships.
Intense Kenny charging. Oh, quick roll up. Man, that would be a ripoff. Oh, Kenny turning the tables. Bridging out Jordan Bradley. And a backslide. Kenny finally kicking out of that series. I don't think he could keep that pace up. Oh. Stiff. Stiff forearm there. Jordan going to work with some dirty boxing. And a bridging pin attempt. To say that the cards are stacked against Grime and Angus is to understate it. And I feel really bad, actually, in hindsight, for letting this match take place, or this tournament. But one thing it's done is really shown some potential amongst our fighters here. Win or lose, this match is happening again at the Massacre. How it'll happen, I'm not sure. Who will hold the belts then? I don't know. Jordan acting cocky. Just getting a one, though. If you have any thoughts or ideas, just send them to us at on our Facebook page. Let our interns deal with it. Someone will get to me. I'm always hearing voices, and I'm sure some of those are the interns. Ooh, Kenny making this a game here. Into the corner. Angus providing those feet, those boots. Jordan Bradley thinking better of it. Angus tagging. Jordan under the swing of Kenny Time. Ultra competitive. Jordan Bradley and Griffin Bradley, at least amongst each other. Oh, what a clothesline. I mean, it was unorthodox and sloppy, but effective. Hard into the corner. Kenny opting for the same tag maneuver. Calling out for the boots. Missing the knee. Griffin tagging himself in. Jordan not appreciative of it, but ref forcing him back out onto the apron. Griffin wanting to go after the big ox Angus. And doing a pretty good job up until now. Angus trying to land that headbutt. Griff. Ken calling Jordan out. I'm not sure he wanted that. That suplex had quite some height and distance, and now wrenching the neck, the back. The referee calling for a rope break. Griffin Bradley must have saw stars in his eyes or something. Got a mouthful of wood there, or vinyl, whatever they did with the mat to make it all nice and crunchy. Kenny with the spear. His eyes glazed over. Gasping for air. He needs a tag. Whipping Angus into the corner. Little assisted Massacre there. Oh, rolled up. He's got him rolled up. Two.
Oh my God. The winners of the match on steel for Squadron Fight Club are Team Champions Griffin and Jordan Bradley, the Bradley Bros.
This is a fun part of the night where Kenny has three entrances to get ready to come take over on commentary, and I get three entrances to get ready to go have my fatal four-way table match for inmate number one contendership. So,
This should be fun, as you can see by the mix. What's going on? Oh, payback. Getting some revenge,
this match,
Zach, huh?
It's a fatal four-way table match. Being fought for the 4th Warden Fight Club Inmate Number 1 Contendership. Introducing first,
Hooligan Owls.
Albert.
I'm here.
Goldman.
I'm dogs and toes.
You didn't change, did you? Well, let me just get ready here.
You ain't got any more on-screen appearances, so it's like, what the hell, you know? Grab the hot dog car and push it on up here.
Alright. Didn't even hit the shower, huh? I guess you didn't have much choice. Alright, well, I'm signing out, because I like to stare in the mirror for a few moments.
Okay, Sacco, you go get your thing going.
Bye, Kenny.
Give me some time with this hot dog.
The second competitor in this match, Earl Skinner.
Gotta digest after that bullshit that went down. Y'all saw it. Firsthand bullshit. What it is. Hold on. Don't eat my hot dogs.
This contest.
I'll do a lot talking, got a
his
memo,
name is Ricky, a young blood Johnson, winner of the season 15 tournament, and R2 whatever title shot he wants in 2016. It is his choice.
Swear to God, it can't be me. Give them dick for the liquor, lucky if they get up free. When she wakes, she be this, so then the goose up in the sea. When she wakes, she watch her tighten up like she.
In the final entrant in this match, for the inmate number one contendership, the owner of 4th Warden Fight Clubs, it is the Maniac,
fight so many fights. A hood maniac is gonna make it better. Now better be me and Angus get a clean shot of them bills. I'm a little pissed about that. It's right here, number one contendership for the MMA title. Table rules, you gotta put your opponent through a table to win. Whoever does it first, they almost, oh, oops, just tossed up some money. Earl Bunny, that big hillbilly. Oh my goodness, Albert is already bleeding. Albert Goldman got a gash inside his head there. Oh man, he's got tunnel bleeding now. Maniac in the corner, withstanding the charge of the bull. Al up there, that table sure is strong. Ricky almost had it for a minute. Skinner down there to the floor. Ricky Johnson on the apron, back in. Maniac taking another spear, another charge. That table was standing quite the blows there. Oh! I think you killed him, man. I think you're supposed to do that to old people. Holy crap, and Al Goldman's still alive and fighting. Maniac hiding in that corner. Oh, Skinner put himself through. That does not count as victory in this type of match. You must put your opponent through it. Not this stupid and ram yourself through a table. If that was the case, man, most of these guys would lose a match all the time. Fighting up there against the crowd, against that the wooden railing. You see our pirate ship theme arena tonight. This intern's doing a wonderful job. Can't believe these kids want to work for free for us. Fuck hell yeah, dude. Do whatever you want, really. Out, just missing that. Oh, Maniac hitting it, but that table too strong. Oh, no. Up against that table there. The table's all over. I just had to eat the more I know. And that little drink will be over real quick. The boss up there. Giving our guests a front row view of sideshow violence. All four men just brawling on the outside. Kenny Time brawling with a hot dog cart and winning. You know, from the outside, hot dog cart looks like it holds a lot of hot dogs. On the inside, oh, double moves on the apron. Skinner looking to finish this, looking to put Maniac through that table. Ricky Johnson bringing them stairs in. Why you want stairs in a table match, man? Talking about my hot dog, and went to take a bite, fell out on the floor, trying to pick it up, missed it. Ricky Johnson just did some kind of last airbender crap there. freak me out even out of this. This meat's bad. Maybe I'm getting hallucinations. Anyway, into the corner. Oh, maniac! Drop kick him like a jump sand through that lumber.
The winner, Anu, Fort Ford and Fight Club, inmate champion, number one contender, it's Maniac.
You know that Boss Man's happy because that inmate title lays close to his heart. That's because he is the man who's brought that inmate title to the fight show. It is his belt originally. Apparently, after Jimmy Johnson found out that the inmate number one contender match was gonna be a table match, he requested Black, Mr. Black, in a match of the same stipulation. Then he had some business to square with him after the event said Caesar's beaten.
This contest is a grudge match and will be fought for the Fort Ford and Fight Club Inmate Championship. The rules will be table match. Introducing first, he is the Fort Ford and Fight Club current Inmate Champion, the superstar Jimmy Johnson.
He's held on to that belt for a long time now. A lot of targets crossing the way, though. You got Maniac, who's got himself number one contendership to that belt now. You got Ricky Johnson, little disciple of Mr. Black, who's got
and the challenger.
He is
the devious Mr. Black.
Dude's been causing trouble for years for the sideshow. Fighters messing up the stuff for us. And you know, the fans don't appreciate the devious on a head tactics. They don't appreciate change. And this is done with players like I do. This is the way I do things. Man, the people love it. You hear them cheering.
This match is an Inmate Title Championship match. The challenger, Mr. Black, and the current reigning Fourth Ward and Fight Club Inmate Champion, the superstar, Jimmy Johnson. The rules of this match are to put your opponent through a table.
Not used to all the ceremony. Man, there's some tension between these two. Although Jimmy Johnson is fresh as you can be, dude. Whereas Mr. Black has already taken a smack from that. Now I'm sounding like a goddamn brand bro. Means I need more beers and hot dogs. Smack. Jimmy said all he wants to do is hurt Mr. Black tonight. He's willing to put his title on the line and do so. Maniac asked him if he wanted to do an interview, and he's like, this is personal. I guess he just wants to stay focused so he can beat up Mr. Black. not get distracted. Oh, very heavy backdrop there. And bust into a dragon screw. Jump an elbow. Jimmy Johnson looking for something. The table will know now. That's right, I forgot we got them, that table involved. Nice to see Maniac working in these a little more violent matches like this. The commissioner and stuff took a lot of balls. Our violence away from us in order to legitimize us, in order for us to achieve our competition license, to meet our insurance. We had to take out, you know, kind of like the sharp edge weapons, and like window panes and explosives, which Jimmy Johnson himself was rather disappointed in. One of our old five-show classic match tops. Explosive minefields. Inferno match. We still got it, but we gotta control the flames. No projectile explosives allowed here. In a moment. Grabbing the table away, and then taking it back. Oh, it rams him. Right in the head of that table. He's looking to finish this. Setting him up, setting that table up in the corner. Mr. Black whipping him. Is he gonna do it? Oh, that power bomb. Powerful, but off the mark, he did not hit the table. Oh no! He went right to the nuts. That's what I mean, you gotta do it with style, man. Call it a stomp to the solar plexus. If you do it all cheesy, it's just rude. Jimmy Johnson is another world of class here. Mr. Black can hope to get lucky. Jimmy with a jawbreaker. Jack him with a jawbreaker. Oh, right to the gut. Whipped in the ropes. Nice hip toss. Jimmy with the neck breaker. He's got fire in his eyes. Deliver that kick, sending the side of Mr. Black's head into that table. And following up with another neck breaker. You can smell the blood in the water here. And another neck breaker. The floppy body slammed down. You can see Jimmy Johnson. He's got foam in his mouth. He's really trying to damage him now. And I think dude's out on his feet. Just fine back by instinct now, Mr. Black. Feel desperate. Yeah, he's got him up. And it draws that suplex. Jimmy Johnson having none of it. Into the corner. Whoa, slam onto that table. He climbs up it and drop kicks off the table. Feeling the fire of the fans behind him. Delivering that flying clothesline for long. Mr. Black. back and I'll fold the trouble. Crowd on their feet, yeah. They're waiting for it. They can feel it. Is this it now? No, Mr. Black. Escaping now, desperation, DDT. Man, that was quite a run. I thought it was over. Mr. Black, measuring him up with that stalling suplex. Right down across the Revolution logo. But Jimmy Johnson is not, he's nowhere near done. He's been through wars, and he's just sent him through a table.
The winner, and still, for Sporting Fight Club in my champion, the superstar, Jimmy Johnson.
Jimmy Johnson exacting his revenge here tonight on Fight Show against Mr. Black, leaving him crumpled, battered, and beaten, and retaining his title. Here we are for main event, folks, for Sporting Fight Club Lightweight Championship. Longtime champion, Zach Shuck, taking on contender, Yogi Von Karen. He was supposed to get the shot at the last Super Show, but Billy Lowenstein robbed him of that chance. Well, tonight, he get a second chance to redeem himself.
Maniac Mike here with Yogi Von Karen. Got the pirate makeover, I see. Are you taking the title shot seriously, or is this all just fun and games?
Yo-ho, dude, yo-ho! Of course I be taking this match seriously. I be the amazing Yargi, most amazing pirate on the 420 seas. And if there be gold for the taking, then take it I shall, dude. The dog has had his toy for far too long. Time for him to step aside. And either walk the planks or be my friend. Yarr, arr, yo, arr.
If I wasn't already insane, I'd swear I was losing my mind.
This match is for the 4th Warden Fight Club Lightweight Championship. Introducing the first, the champion, current reigning 4th Warden Fight Club lightweight champion, Zach Shuck.
And you have to wonder, whatever Mr. Black did to him earlier, just how much that'll affect him in this match. Not to mention the focus it takes to defend a belt. Will he have it?
And the challenger, one of the brothers three, he is not the biggest, but the most amazing, Yogi Von Karen.
Yeah, before you ask, the Von Karens all wrote their own intros this week. We just make them do readable.
This main event is being fought for the Lightweight Championship. The contender, the amazing Yogi, and the current reigning 4th Warden Fight Club lightweight champion, Zach Shuck.
Nice. Production crew doing a pretty snap-up job just until right there, the main event champion. Closer. How about that, Zach? Yogi Bomb carrying. Dressed up like a pirate. Hopefully he has more success than his brothers did. They got killed. Oh yeah, that was me and Angus, which laid a massive creep plot down on them. Yogi, working on the midsection, and as we said, we really don't know how much damage Mr. Blackdome did to Zach Shook during whatever happened in the locker room. We saw Sam being warned to find Zach Shook, and we assume none of the other Von Karens are underhanded enough to do something to Zach Shook. Zach landing that kick square to the face of Yogi, working on the neck. Zach goes for immediate payoff, so he'll work the joint, looking for loosen something up, grab a hold of it, start trying to rip it off, make you tap out. Woo! Yogi is going crazy. It's amazing. And a roll up, 1, 2. Oh, it's reverse, 2. It could be, no. That was close. That was close with both of them into the corner. And reverse, Yogi. Oh, his foot got caught. Dodging out of the way of that kick. Landing his own back. So hard to keep a hold of. His hands and arms are so strong. They're all wiry. Always got that sleeper hold wrapped around him. He's got the scissor, bottle scissors. This could be over for Yogi. And but Yogi's rolling out of it. Snap me up. Reversing that. And going back with them big steel toes. I ain't never seen no pirate with steel toes, but I seen Yogi Von Karen not a day in his life without them. Beautiful swinging neck breaker. That Shook going crazy. He said, man, you pissed me off. Hit the love. Action is fast and furious in this main event. Oh, catching a big boot in the face. Neck breaker. That Shook choking him now. It's all legal, man. We checked. It is a submission move. Zach's got him in the ropes. Choking him now. Working on taking that air supply away. Yogi trying to come back. Working that knee with that drop kick. He's laying in line and late moves to that leg. Trying to slow them kicks down. Oh, man, this is crazy action. Oh, Zach looking to put this away. He's got them hands wrapped around that neck. Yogi not done yet. Oh, flipping drop kick. Yogi Von Karen. Oh, kick up. Holy crap, they're matching each other move for move, folks. The champion, the challenger, Zach Shook, looking to put this one away. Yogi Von Karen looking bad now. The stomp to all them pressure points, it is over. It's all over now. 1, 2. Oh my God, Yogi kicked out. What the hell, man? He been eating his Wheaties or something. Yogi Von Karen looking through in such dire straits. Zach got him up, spider stuplet. Trying to put him away, and Yogi moves. He dodges it. Holy crap, What the hell's going on? You did it! Oh my god, y'all, we're about to get into the beat. Vet Shook is the new lightweight champion. Holy crap, Vet Shook looks out. Surprise, too, man.
The winner in move, first one in Fight Club, lightweight champion, the amazing Yorgi.
What's up with the Master Creed coming at you?